was a man who could never understand the shame on a written man's face. So they lived in the hills and they never came down, but to trade in the white man's place. It was early in the spring when the snow had disappeared. They came down with a bag of skins. In the fall of the year of 1910, Daddy died by the rope down in Cherokee Bend. Daddy didn't like what the white man said about the dirty little kid at his side. Daddy didn't like what the white man did, though they feel the way that he lied. There was blood on the floor of the government store when the man took his daddy away. But the boy stayed back till he come to his end, and he run like the wind from Cherokee Bend. Now the mother was alone and the winter was at hand, and she prayed to her spirit kin. It was warm in the lodge in the Kentucky hills on the day when the boy came in. Then a blizzard came down and it covered up the door till they thought that it never would end. And he told her the tale of the terrible affair in the government store down at Cherokee Bend. Daddy didn't like what the white man said about the dirty little kid at his side. Daddy didn't like what the white man did, nor the deal of the way that he lied. 3 long days and 3 long nights, they wept and they mourned, and then she returned to her work and her weaving, and they tried to forget about Cherokee Bend. Now the boy wasn't big, but he hunted what he could, and he lived for a time that way. But the food ran low and the meat went bad, and she said to the boy one day, "I'm leaving tonight and I never will return from my land of the spirit kin. You must take what you need and trade what you can for a red man's grave down at Cherokee Bend." Wasn't very long till she closed her eyes and he wrapped her in a robe. He found her a place on the side of the hill and he buried her in the snow. Early in the spring he was seen in the town with his boat looking ragged and thin. Not a year had gone by till he stood once again in the government store down at Cherokee Bend. He was 10 years tall and a redskin too, so he hadn't much face to save. And the men sat around and they laughed and they clowned at the talk of the criminal's grave. Then the man from the east didn't smile when he said, "You're the son of an Indian scum. If you value your hide, you better abide by the white man's rules here in Cherokee Bend." Daddy didn't like what the white man said about the dirty little kid at his side. Daddy didn't like what the white man did, the deal or the way that he lied. Spit on the floor of the government store, it served him to no good end. At the close of the day, they had taken him away to the white men's school down at Cherokee Bend. It's been 21 years since the boy had disappeared. Where he run to, nobody knows. But they say he fell in with a man named Jim, and he rides in the rodeos. And they say he returns all alone to a place hidden deep in the Kentucky Glen. And it's pretty well known who hauled up the stone to the grave on the hill above Cherokee Bend. Daddy didn't like what the white man said about the dirty little kid at his side. Daddy didn't like what the white man did, nor the deal or the way that he lied. The blood on the floor of the government store when the man took his daddy away. He was 1910 and he never had a friend when he died by the road down at Cherokee Bend. He was 1910 and he never had a friend when he died.